Today, I'm going to talk about the nutritional and health benefits of rice bran oil. It's going to be a short presentation. And of course, we all are going to vouch for it. And at the outset, I would just like to say, though 13 is unlucky number for the West, but today 13 number is going to be the lucky number for Indians, because I can see my quite a few nutritionists and dietitians who are going to vouch for the oil and they are going to use in their daily practice. So I'm very happy when they are there with us today. As far as the nutritionists and dietitians are concerned, when the patient goes to the doctor would advise, rule out the disease, diagnosis and all. Further, they refer it to nutritionists and dietitians. But when it goes to the nutritionists and dietitians, there are many myths and facts are coming out, because everybody is having certain kinds of myths and facts about it, whether the fat is going to be healthy, whether I should avoid fat, or it's going to be a cholesterol levels are going to be high. All these things are there in our back of our mind. But why it is so? Because is it because of the diet, or it's a lifestyle, as Dr. Prakash also pointed out, or it's the junk food, fried food, what? India is having quite a few diseases in last 20 years which were not there much in order, as a cardiovascular diseases are increasing day by day, along with other disease, and of course TB is relapsing again and again in Indian condition. Is it due to improper dietary habits or nutritionally weak foods? Today we are going to discuss about the thing, why it is so, and when it goes to the consumer, what happens? The consumer is really confused about the whole issue, whether it's a helplessness or sometimes fear of the fat. We as a crowd who all understand well about the oils and fat should give them the right kind of message, and this kind of anger or worry should be not there, and they should always feel they are in the safe hand and the safe food is there for them also. What way Indians are looking at the food? We all know the basic survival days were there where roti was required for the population. But now, after independence, even the food is for pleasure. Look at the dancing doll. Along with this, they are looking even for the specialized nutrition. This specialized nutrition is required to dance like this also, and along with certain antioxidants, of course. But the World Health Organization is giving us quite a few guidelines. Here are the doctors and scientists scratching the head and talking about the oil. How much to be given? What's the safe limit? Whether these are SFA, MUFA, PUFA, of course my previous speaker has in great manner highlighted the things. And what about the ratio? The buzzword is there, omega-3. What is omega-3? Why it is important for me or for my family? All those things are there, and of course not to forget about trans fatty acid. The population is becoming well-versed, and thanks to the labeling. The labeling people have told the companies they have to put on label about the amount of trans fat. Of course, this has been already discussed by my previous speaker also. So I'm just going to look at from the point of view omega-3, omega-6 and omega-9 fatty acids, and the different kinds of a majority of the fats. The composition of vegetable oils. We all prefer to have certain kinds of oil in our house. It might be due to taste, flavor, sometimes composition, or we may say from inherited we are using the oil. So we prefer to have the same kind of oil in our daily diet. But look at the antioxidant levels, and here the RBO stands out different. because of tocopherol, tocotrienol, or isonol, and very close at the same time to the recommendation of the World Health Organization as far as the ratio is concerned, or SFA, MUFA, or PUFA is concerned. We have number of oils in India. In each corner, we have a different oil. If you go to southern part, people are using different oil. If you go to the northern region, they are having a typical kind of oil. And even the costly oil, it's like olive oil is like a Ferrari car having in the at the doorstep, and olive oil is also gaining the market, but Indian olive oil is definitely rice bran oil. What kind of fatty acid composition one should look for? There are few oils I've picked up here, which are generally in routinely we use it, starting with the peanut and soya bean and cottonseed oil. They have a different composition. All this different composition makes a difference in the quality parameter or indicators as far as health is concerned. As Goenkaji rightly pointed out, that rice bran oil is the most preferred oil for blending, and it has been endorsed by so many companies: Godrej, Marico, Sundrop Heart, Sundrop Nutrilite. Each of them have picked up only rice bran oil as a blended oil to be blended with their routine blend or routine oil what they have, and improving the fatty acid ratio as far as saturated is concerned or PUFA is concerned. And this is becoming close to the World Health Organization endorsement also. Why? India is changing, the climate is ripening for the healthy oil, the premium pricing oil. But along with the technology, and as Dr. V. Prakash rightly pointed out, safe food is essential. The food has to be safe for the population. So the further we have a good lifestyle is essential, but we are like a lion. But when we are caught with the disease, it's like a net in surrounding lion. We all have studied this story in our school days, but the phytochemicals are like mouse, and they are in present in micro amounts, but at the same time, they are essential. And when we can get from the diet, nothing like that. The lion becomes helpless when the net is around, but the phytochemicals can remove this net and the lion would be free. The healthy person will be remaining more healthy, and of course the properly they will have a fitness and wellness also. What are the phytosterols? They are like a small mouse, but they are there in the body. Then cholesterol levels will not become high, and of course Dr. Chokolingam's business will go down little if phytochemicals are enough taken every day through the diet also. What are they? Is it the picture is saying something? Chemicals. Is it the environment of this two girls are fighting? No. These are the phytochemicals present in rice bran oil. There are two varieties of rice bran oil, you can say, or types of rice bran oil: chemically refined and physically refined. Chemically refined has chemicals utilized for it, whereas for physically refined, enzymes are used. They are much more healthier, and one can say the oresonal levels, phytosterol levels are higher compared to chemically refined ones. We all understand the therapeutic doses are available. If I have to take grapes from the market, I'll go for seedless grapes. But believe me, the seed has the phytochemicals. One should go for it. So vitamin E, instead of taking supplement, naturally present in the food is essential. Along with vitamin E, each and every cosmetics are available. Therapeutic doses are there, but they are, of course, isolated or chemically prepared. Things are added to it either for improvement of the skin or wrinkle-less skin. Many types of nutraceuticals are available. What they do, this kind of antioxidants, either looking at the heart or liver or reducing obesity sometimes, or they are called as functional foods. Also, the new buzzword is there, helping the respiratory system also to function at the best, and in turn, improving the immunity of a healthy person. What kind of nutraceuticals are there in RBO? There is a long list, starting from orisonal, tocotrienol, tocopherol, and the new word has been added to it is lipoic acid. Of course, this lipoic acid stabilizes blood sugar, which is a boon to diabetic people. Choline is there. All these things are therapeutically available in the cosmetics also, but at the same time, they are doing their job in a wonderful manner as an anti-cancer or tumor suppression also. Is there any clinical advantage of rice bran oil? What are they? If it is yes, then what are they and how it is going to be there? Look at the hexagon where obesity is in the middle and other diseases are revolving around it. Are we looking at the defense against it? Look at the man. He is having a cylinder as well as a saline or glucose also, but he's little worried about the report. Why? Is he suffering from any disease or he requires defense against the particular disease? It might be heart disease, Parkinson's or cancer. So this kind of antioxidants taken, they are having a beneficial effects towards the disease also. As far as the heart diseases are concerned, the maximum research has been done over the world, and they are also endorsing that rice bran oil showed the maximum cholesterol lowering effect as compared to our traditional oils also. And with this a short period of span, it was not a very long time, one has to take it. Certain arrows are in other direction also. There are many more factors to it to rule out. It's not only the one factor, but there are many more factors for lowering cholesterol levels in person's body also. Again, it has been endorsed by the research work. Here we can see the span of rice bran oil within a week time showed the maximum beneficial effect. And believe me, this research work had a 60 gram of oil given to the animals also and observed the effect. So why RBO? The lady is dancing with the food. The mouse is giving the reply. Is it safe? Is it good for health? It's easily available. I think even I need to say, in Goa also, when recently I visited, even they are consuming rice bran oil, but definitely even they would like to have a rice bran oil available there also. So please, the advantage. There are culinary advantage as well as health advantages as far as RBO is concerned. I'm just going to talk about the economics of it. When we have a fried food, the oil absorption is little less than the normal oil. That's an advantage to us. If we really work out cost-benefit ratio, it's not going to be costly oil at all. Of course, sticky dust is less as far as the food is concerned. I think Dr. Prakash just said rat and cat cannot be together. Here, they are together. The cats are very happy because they have mouse with them as an antioxidant and the food for them. A nutritionally balanced diet, it is essential to have rice bran oil. What consumer prefers? Is it the good taste all the time? The consumer acceptance of the product is changing. the scenario is changing in India. Certain types of brands are available, and even I have tried to rule out, Dr. Prakash, as you pointed out, it's not available. People don't know about much of the brands. There are many brands available in Mumbai too. I've just tried to request Dr. Mehta about it also. Each oil has a different health benefit. So each rice bran oil can be having a different kind of health benefit as far as the population is concerned. There are consumers, the literate, highly educated consumers look for the food which are nutritious but with some added nutrition also. What do you mean by with added nutrition? Is it antioxidant or any other substance? I think it's a time we need to change our vision. It's the edible oil, we talk a lot about it. But what kind and why we need to change our own vision as far as the oils are concerned? Look at the thing. So, say cheers to the life, and we need to change our own vision. Of course, I'm not talking about beer here at all. It's the rice bran oil requires vision, and definitely it's a good oil to utilize in daily life also. And remember, the best option of our life and the gift from nature is rice bran oil. We need to enjoy the nature and take a support of nature for the healthy life throughout. I'm hopeful for the great tomorrow across the globe. As far as the rice bran oil is concerned, it has been endorsed from the East world and echoing from the West world. Even they are coming up with a research work that rice bran oil is a good oil for the health. And I'm posted to conclude my session. If you have any suggestion, it's most welcome. And thank you very much for giving me time.